So one more round of point plotting here, so or graphing rational expressions. So again, we begin everything by looking at the zeros upstairs and downstairs, which requires factoring. So on the bottom, if we factor that, that's x plus 1 times x plus 1. And upstairs, I have a 3x and an x. And I think we'll be good with a 4. And 1 plus minus. I believe that's it. 4x minus 3x. Yep, we got it. All right, and so we have basically upstairs my zeros are negative 4 and 3 over 3. X equals 1. And down below we have x equals negative 1, and it's of multiplicity 2. And so at this stage of the game, none of my zeros match up, so there's no holes. Upstairs here, these guys are telling me where my x-intercepts are at. So one of them is at negative 4/3 0, and the other is at 1, 0. And then we definitely have a vertical asymptote at x equals negative 1, right? And there's no holes because there's no zeros. There's no common factor. So we're off to the races. So my next item up for bid, so we did step 1. Step 2 is not necessary. So step 3. What's the end behavior? I notice that my degrees match, right? I have a degree 2 equals a degree 2. So my horizontal asymptote is my lead coefficient divided by my lead coefficient. So my horizontal asymptote is y equals 3. And at the bare minimum, right, my fourth step is to at least find our y-intercept. Am I crossing the y-axis and where? So we'll find f of 0, and so that's the y-intercept. And if we plug that in there, everything is going to go to 0, so we're left with negative 4 over 1. Can I cut to the chase like that? And so we get 0, negative 4. Interesting, a lot of my graphs go through 0, negative 4. I might have to change that in some other videos. But at any rate, right, so let's see if this is enough information to graph our function. So negative 1 is a vertical asymptote. Alrighty. Y equals 3 is a horizontal asymptote. All right, we got that. We know we're crossing the x-axis at negative 4/3 0, so about right there. We know we're crossing the x-axis at 1, 0, right about there. All right, and we know we're crossing the y-axis at 0, negative 4. So if I put all everything on this side together, what I have is a graph that's doing that. Okay, because my multiplicity is 2, I know this function is doing that, and then chances are this function is probably coming up and doing something of that nature. All right, so there again is a pretty rough sketch of what our function looks like. Okay, however, I do know a little bit more about this function. It does turn out, and so this might be appropriate. I've been kind of avoiding it until this one. You may want to follow the book's advice by finding where we cross the horizontal asymptote. So we might want to, at a bare minimum, do that, rule out that it doesn't happen, or rule out, because this one, I'm actually wrong with this. Because if we do go through where will we equal to 3, so I got to basically find where does my function equal to 3. So this means 3x squared plus x minus 4 all over x squared plus 2x plus 1 is equal to 3. Treat that as 3 over 1 and do a quick cross multiplication. We get 3x squared plus x minus 4. This would be 3 times x squared plus 2x plus 1. And so 3x squared plus x minus 4. This gives us 3x squared plus 6x plus 3. The 3x squareds will cancel out when I subtract. If I subtract 6x from both sides and add 4, what we end up getting is negative 5x equals 7. And if we divide by negative 5, we get that we actually cross this. So negative 7/5 comma 3 is a point on the graph. So that's roughly negative 1, and it's a little bit past this, so it's about right there. So what this tells me then, to get the graph right, let me correct it with red, right, is the graph actually comes up, crosses this axis. Because this behavior is already going down here, I know it's not going up, but it's got to come back, so it's going to peak out somewhere, and then come back and hug that axis. So I'm just making use of the fact of what happens in the horizontal axis. We eventually have to come back. So I know I'm crossing the horizontal asymptote, but I'm not going to positive infinity because the asymptotic behavior means I'm going to negative infinity in this direction. So I've got to be going up somewhere, but I have to come back down because the end behavior tells me I've got to do that. And so in red there, there's basically our sketch to that. And I learned a little bit with the book. You might want to go ahead and always find, like I suggested here, not just find the y-intercept, but you might want to also do the extra work and see do we cross the horizontal asymptote, because that plays a role as well, especially in this last example. There you have it. The next one, same analysis. We can clearly see we have a zero down below, and it's of multiplicity 3. So that tells us that the vertical asymptote is at x equals 2, or at least we hope it is, right? There's no holes, and we've got that. If we factor the top factors as x minus 4 and x plus 1. Yeah. All right, so my zeros upstairs are 4 and negative 1 respectively, and my zero down on the bottom is 2. So if I follow along with my step 1 and step 2, there's no common zeros, there's no common factors, so no simplification. So my x-intercepts are at 4, 0, and negative 1, 0, and my vertical asymptote is x equals 2. There's no holes, so I don't have to worry about that. So step 1, step 2 are done. Step 3, what's the end behavior? Well, upstairs, my degree is 2. Downstairs, my degree is 3. So this tells us that we have a horizontal asymptote, and it's basically the x-axis, y equals to 0. So far, so good. Step 4, let's find the y-intercept. And I learned my lesson. We're also going to find where we cross the horizontal asymptote. So in this case, my y-intercept, we're going to plug 0 in there. Again, if we plug 0 in here, this all goes away, and we're left with negative 4. If we plug 0 in here, we have negative 2 cubed, which is negative 8. So we get a half. So we are crossing the y-axis at 0 and a half. What about a crossing of the horizontal asymptote? Well, that's asking, when does f of x equal to 0? So when does x squared minus 3x minus 4, right, all over x minus 2 cubed equal to 0? But doing a quick cross multiplication, we find that we're basically solving that. And we actually have already done that. Those are basically our x-intercepts, which is that. So we kind of, by default, found it where we were crossing the horizontal asymptote anyways, because my asymptote, right, horizontally, matched my x-intercept. So I think we're good to go. So let's put this together. So first of all, we have a vertical asymptote at 2. So we got that. We have a horizontal asymptote being the x-axis. So we've got that. We are actually crossing the x-axis at 4, 0 and at negative 1, 0. And I have a y-intercept at 0 and a half. So what does this tell us right now? This tells us that this graph, right, is in this direction, has to be doing this. Got to be doing that, all right? Because as we approach two from this direction, we're already above the x-axis, and if I was to go down, we would have found another x-intercept, and we didn't. So we have to be doing this. Here we're crossing, so maybe it's coming down a little bit, but eventually it has to come back up and hug the x-axis, because that's my horizontal asymptote. Over here, well, what I'm going to do is use the fact that we know the multiplicity is 3. So if we're going to positive infinity in this direction, I've got to be going to negative infinity in that direction. I've got to cross the x-axis, so that means we probably come up above it a little bit, but then come back down. All right, and so there, using what we've learned about multiplicities and vertical asymptotes and x-intercepts and all that other stuff, there's my my graph of that function using our graph analysis for rational functions. All right, so hopefully that's enough examples to kind of walk you through that step-by-step process. Again, I know it's a lot of labor-intensive stuff, but there's a lot of good math going on that will help you in a lot of other arenas. So please don't just rely on your calculator, right? Use it as a source to check, but make sure you understand the algebra that's going on. If you have questions you need to ask, come see me for an office hour. We can do some more examples together. Post your attempts on Canvas and we can talk about them, whatever it takes. All right, we'll wrap this up in one more video coming soon where we start doing some curve fitting. We reverse this process.